Welcome to your natal chart report. This is the Peace Dealer, and I hope you gain the utmost of quality from this report. We, of course, are going to look into your natal chart, and right off the bat, we do see that you were born a gangster, a straight up G. This is actually quite unexpected because I forgot to see you were born in 75. So you do have Saturn on your sun, which now sets you up to have a very important alien construct, which I will reference through this alien construct article. And having Saturn on your sun, similar to 50 Cent, who was born, I believe, around this time period, y'all can manifest from the heart, turn times backwards and forward, create successful empires, manifest anything in the three-dimensional reality, recognize false leaders, ego-driven schemes. And 50 Cent is definitely someone that I will profile on my channel, because this is definitely one of the greatest representatives I've ever seen, especially that has been, you know, successful in this 3D world, regarding, you know, this archetype, especially because, like you, he also has a Gemini moon. So if anything, I wonder if he was born 75. But other than that, this makes you a legendary sun moon signature, because your moon is 12th house from your sun. And so this gives you the vibration of enlightened sincerity, where you're the angel high priestess as solar queen Stephanie, because Leo rising gives your title as queen. Okay. So not only are you queen, but you're a total gangster. I have to really emphasize your gangsterness, because Saturn adds this no nonsense approach to how seriously you actually overcome limitations and challenges designed to hold you back the first 30 years of your life. And this is why I had to reference 50 Cent, who's not only undeniably gangster, but really influenced the whole shape of hip hop and the world by really bringing that image and nature and persona to the industry or to culture. Okay. Despite how controversial it may have been. The reason why I also like to profile 50 Cent, as far as the power of Saturn on your sun, Saturn is the totality of the world and success. So contemplate that 50 Cent made, I think, over $100 million selling water. And he's a water sign. He has Saturn and a water sign. So like Saturn is literally his ability to sell water, but like at such a large capacity, that just blows my mind. It's legendary, right? So that being said, we see you also have Juno on your sun. Juno attached to woman especially is a very powerful indicator of royalty, because Juno is the queen goddess who was married to Jupiter, the king of the gods. And any woman who I've ever seen with this attached to their sun, moon, or rising has this presence about them. The Juno is the good wife. So they have those qualities, but they're just also very powerful, influential, and or have a regalness about them. Every single person I've seen with this, it's very fascinating. I want to make a special video or documentary about this. So this is very interesting, seeing that we have Saturn on and Juno on either end. And attached to the 12th house, this is also key, because this indicates primarily that you have a legendary quality to your spirit, as you may be hidden here in the 12th, especially Saturn is never easy on the 12th. A lot of limitations or challenges in career may be hidden, and you may be misunderstood. It may be hard to convince people that elements of the government or corporations may privately hate on you and could be your hidden enemy, or you could just have difficulty or may have had difficulty. And I have to say this carefully, because things that are hard in the 12th house actually become a superpower once you once the self-sabotage element is released. Because as an element of a weakness, 12th house Cancer could be you being stuck or too sensitive in your emotions, or perhaps because you're so psychic, you may be restless in what you're picking up that you feel that other people don't feel. And Cancer is the most gaslighted zodiac sign. So you could be stuck in a 12 here where people just don't really believe what you're picking up because it's unseen, right? But when you just fully surrender, because the lesson of the 12th house is to believe in Cancer what you feel, even if no one else believes you. When you fully surrender to that need to be right or to be believed or to just the environment, this becomes a transcendent total superpower that with Saturn gives you the ability to manipulate and control emotions in yourself and influence or manipulate them in others. Okay. Because Saturn here also holds accountable the sincerity of people's emotions. This is what's going to make you very serious about how you feel. And there is a power and authority that you've attained since your Saturn return that links with this. That being said, this squaring Uranus and Jupiter make for a most powerful T-square. And relative to this powerful T-square, it really indicates very primarily the genius nature of your attitude. You have a very genius social attitude that enables you to know who is who when you walk in any social situation. I mean, Leo is the main character. So your personality is that of the performer on stage. And with Venus mastered 28 degrees, you're very beautiful. Anyone who I've ever met with or just scientifically speaking, Venus on AC applies beauty to one's personality. So your physical image is beautiful. And in Leo, it's hot. So like this is going to gravitate a lot of, you know, attention towards you. I have Mercury. So Mercury on my AC makes me more mercurial and I'm seen to be more of like a nerd. Or like someone who kind of like communicates. Venus is going to be more the model. It's going to be more the beauty. All right. And this attached to your personality brings a sense of charm, but also heartfelt passion that as the main character on stage, sextiling Uranus adds such an unconventionality to how genius and intelligently you can communicate this passion and vibrance as attached to your personality. This is seen in the charts of child prodigies because you innovate the nature of learning. Like Uranus in the third doesn't have to apply to you, but you may have done poorly in school because like you realize the way they taught you was BS. And so you may not have really, you have a high IQ, but you may have like not taken school seriously as you could. This could also denote that you pass school with flying colors, but it's common to see in this, like people who don't really take their school seriously because you're too smart for it. Like you've seen through the system, especially seeing Jupiter in the ninth. You have an ability to teach people in a way that's so unconventional. It's not like, oh, I write this on a chalkboard and you regurgitate information. You make learning dynamic and original for people. You're able to teach people subject matter in a way that applies specifically to who they are as a person. And so Jupiter is very amazing here in the ninth. And it adds a very bold, dynamic, powerful way of showing people, you know, the higher meaning of their character. It also is attached to the healing that's very bold and assertive. So Uranus here, regardless in the third, innovates the way you apply social interactions to teach people things. And this could also indicate claircognizant social functions and actions that can come off as telepathy because now your moon trining this with Mercury. Mercury in its dignity in Gemini gives you a very magical ability to communicate highly intelligently because your mind processes information at lightning speed, subruled by Uranus. Trining Uranus, adding more claircognizant alignment to how the information your brain processes instantly links to direct application of how the information your mind is processing applies directly to who you're speaking to. So like you can of course process, okay, this is what somebody has, but then you'll instantly see how it applies to what they're doing and how to actually communicate that to them. And that's a skill and that's genius, period. And Pluto will also add more intensity and extremeness to this nature of your attitude. So that with Neptune on your North Node in Sagittarius, this unlocks the nature of the visions you clairvoyantly pick up on. It's just, this energy is so genius for you. You may register this as thoughts instead of any mystical visions and insights. But you are super psychic. So this is where the square in your 12th, you want to be careful of, because you now provide this unconventional, supernatural, ultimate, awareness of the deeper meaning of how you feel or what you pick up in other people's feelings. And this is how you're able to apply this originally into how it also impacts other people's characters. So this could be very controversial, but it's supernatural. And when you approach it from that angle, it actually ironically makes more sense. We do also see you have Mars in Taurus next to Isis. Your MC in Taurus, with, of course, the eclipse, is going to manifest a unique and unconventional sense of success that can even set up a monopoly. In that, no one else is, of course, manifesting the brand and career you're manifesting. So this can literally, of course, lessen any comparative advantage other people have or competition. And this is important because with Mars attached to this, the way you take action is very determined. You're someone who is slow to act, but you finish the job. You take your time and you take action based on the values you stand on. So this actually denotes physical strength and determination that will see you reach success in any career goals you have because of how grounded the actions you take towards said success are. And this will continue to go a long way towards influencing and inspiring so much of how you impact individually other people. Okay. It's also very important to realistically tap into your own personal insights. The way I'm going to end this reading is that your awareness of psychic phenomena is going to be retarded or delusional to other people, but you're a super psychic gangster. So it's not necessarily that you're in a position to have to, you know what I'm saying? Prove yourself. You don't want to get into the trap of proving yourself to people. If people are stupid and think you're crazy, then they missed out on the wisdom that you're providing. But for people who really listen to you, you're going to hook them up. You're going to provide an awareness that they may not have the wisdom to understand. And as weird as it may, seem, it's essential. Okay. Regardless, I hope you enjoy this report. You stay blessed as always. And until next time, peace.